Hello everyone! Today we're going to learn how to draw a nice river using the Riz tool of Illustrator for strokes, and we're also going to spice it up with some pollution in our river, and we will apply a gradient onto the stroke to do this. So, let's get started!
We will start by creating a new document. You can click on OK. And now we take the pen tool, this one over here, or the pencil tool to draw our river. In this case, I choose the pencil tool, just draw some lines like this, and you can actually use the smooth tool to smooth it out a little bit. So if you have any corners that you don't like so much, you can make them a little bit smoother like this. But this should be fine for now. We can then select our line and maybe zoom in a little bit. And now we can go ahead and select our Riz tool. This is this one here. We click on this. And if we now click on our path, click and drag, we can increase the width of our river. You can also change the width at several points in your river. For example, we can try to make a little lake in here. Like this. And if you press the Alt key, you can change the size of only one of the sides of your stroke. So we can also adjust our little lake. Something like this. Maybe we should increase the size over here a little bit more. And there we have our nice river. Let's give this one a blue color. We can find the blue in the sources panel. And there's our river. Next, we can go ahead and add some pollution into our river. To do this, we're going to use the gradient panel. You find this over here. And in this case, I have the stroke selected. If it's not selected like this, just click on here to select your stroke. And we double click in here to activate this gradient onto our river. At the moment, it's filled from the left to the right, but we want the stroke to follow our river. So we click on this symbol over here. And now, of course, we need to change the color of the water. We give this one a blue color again. Just double click in here and click on the color. And to add some more points into our gradient, you can just click below the blue box here to add some more points. One of those we're going to change into a green. Yeah, maybe this is a good green. And then we make sure that the gradient starts at some point and fades out at the other end. Let's move those over here. We try to get a really sharp edge where we get our pollution into the river. Let's take a look at this. Yeah, and this looks quite nice. And by the way, should you decide you want to get rid of this little lake, you can always go back to the Riz tool, and by double clicking on this point, you can choose to delete the point. Click on delete, and your little lake is gone.
Alright, thanks for watching. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, there is now also a Facebook page, and I would be really happy if you give this a like. You'll find the link in the YouTube description. Until next time, bye bye!